I'm currently in the middle of running 200 marathons around the world to raise awareness about the water crisis, to show the urgency of the problem that we're facing. Even just saying that just sounds completely ridiculous, let alone thinking, you know, I'm 172 marathons in, 28 to go. I've got to confess, I'm not a runner. So it was like the most ridiculous, ambitious thing I can imagine. I don't like running. I don't come from a running background. I'm not naturally talented at running. So this whole thing was completely outside my comfort zone. But to make big change, we've got to do things that are uncomfortable. We've got to accept that we can do those hard things that are needed in order for us to make the change that we need. Over the last 10 months, I have been to the front lines of this crisis. I've met the people who are suffering from the problems. I've seen and met the people who are working on the solutions. I've seen in the Pantanal wetlands, the wetlands are drier than they've ever been. The water levels are lower than they've ever been. In the Aral Sea, an inland ocean that used to be the fourth biggest inland ocean in the world, where the earth was so dry, I could literally run across it between these massive carcasses of shipping boats lying marooned in the sand. I've met the farmers in Turkey who are working their way around these massive sinkholes that have opened up in the ground because of overuse of groundwater. Or whether it's the women and girls in India who are walking for hours each day, risking their lives to go and fetch water. This is not just a problem that exists in one place. This is a global problem that exists across the planet. Climate change is water change, and climate risk is water risk.
Many of the problems that we see and we feel with water nowadays are a consequence of the climate change that we are living in. And water is the first area where we as human beings perceive climate change so close. It's either too little water or too much water or water at the wrong time. The biggest consumption in water is from the food we eat, from the clothes we wear, from everything we consume.
Less than 10% of water is used by us at home, 70% by agriculture, 20% by manufacturing. So if we're really going to make a change, that's where we need to go.
We know that agriculture is one of the big impacts in climate change. And usually, where you have big impacts, you also have opportunities for big solutions. When we talk about agriculture and water, we have to talk about rice. Rice is the staple that feeds half of the worldwide population, 4 billion people, and at the same time consumes 30 to 40% of the fresh water available to all of us in the world. In conventional rice farming, paddies are flooded with standing water to prevent weeds from growing. Rice loves the water, and weeds don't. It also keeps the soil soft to help when farmers transplant the young crops. But all that water does something else. It deprives the soil of oxygen. This creates a breeding ground for bacteria. These bacteria are harmless to the rice, but they produce methane gas, which is harmful to our climate. The longer the field is flooded, the more bacteria grow and more emissions are created. We have been working since several years in an alternative methodology called dry-seeded rice to grow rice without the use of that much amount of water. Direct-seeded rice can be planted directly on the field without having to flood the fields. This has many effects, as for example, it will prevent the emission of methane, and it will also support the workers in the farm by making their labor much less intensive. Imagine how much water is needed to grow 1 kilogram of rice. It's about 3,000 liters. And now imagine you are able to save 30 to 40% of that. And now we don't talk about kilograms, but we talk about tons and tons. So it means that we will be able to save billions of cubic meters of water around the world once we are able to introduce this technology. Now, change takes time, and adoption takes time.
ਤਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਕੋਈ 30-35 ਸਾਲ ਦਾ ਖੇਤੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਹਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਨਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਕੀਤੀ ਪਰ ਬੱਚਾ ਸਾੜਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੰਨਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਵੀ ਮੈਂ 3.5-3 ਕਿੱਲੇ ਸਿੱਧੀ ਬਿਜਾਈ ਦੇ ਕਰਕੇ ਦੇਖਣੇ ਆ ਜਿਹਨੂੰ ਮੈਂ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੱਦੂ ਕਰਕੇ ਬਈਆਂ 'ਤੇ ਜੀਰੀ ਲਗਾਉਣੀ ਹੈ ਪਰ ਉਹ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਨੇ ਮੰਨੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਬਾਤ ਮੇਰੀ ਇਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਜੀਰੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧੀਆ ਹੋ ਗਈ ਕੋਈ ਬਹੁਤਾ ਪਾਣੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਲਾਉਣਾ ਪਿਆ ਬਹੁਤੇ ਕੋਈ ਸਾਡੇ ਖਰਚੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਏ ਉਹਦੇ ਪਰ ਇਹ ਬਹੁਤ ਅੱਛੀ ਜੀਰੀ ਨਿਕਾਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਿਕਲਦੀ ਹੈ ਬਹੁਤ ਅੱਛੀ ਖੜੀ ਆ ਹੁਣ ਇਹਦੇ ਖਰਚੇ ਘੱਟ ਆ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ
Rice, the way we see it in a conventional way, relies on lots of handwork of people going in the field and collecting the rice manually. Direct-seeded rice is less labor-intensive, which has a huge benefit as the time that is not needed for this task will be able to be invested in others, in increasing education, in having other jobs, in growing other professional opportunities. Sustainability embraces everything, embraces improving planet's health and embraces improving people's livelihoods. And improving people's livelihoods means improving health, improving access to resources, improves access to education, and at the end of the day, being able to choose the life that you want to live.
Sometimes, to make big, global, substantive change, you've got to show people the power of what's possible. Not only we have a problem, but here are the solutions. And by the way, we can do this, even though it requires us to do hard things. We must be optimistic and we must take the future into our own hands and we must accept that this is our problem and we can be part of the solution. Because to accept anything else, it's not possible.